Time blocking is a concept used by millions of people every single day, and it's very simply dragging a task onto your calendar and allowing that time slot to essentially focus in on the work. Well, Akiflow have made this even better with something called time slot. We're going to show you how it works and also some of the other time blocking abilities inside of Akiflow. Today's feature is a feature spotlight, which is sponsored by Akiflow to dive into a new feature that they have. You can check out Akiflow if you're interested in it below, and naturally download it if you fancy it. We also have a new discount coupon, which you can find below, and a full review on Toolfinder if you are looking to learn a little bit more about it before you dive in. So this is a fairly new feature to Akiflow, but before you could essentially drag something from your inbox all the way over to your calendar. And for those who don't know how Akiflow works, is you can bring in tasks from other applications like Slack, Gmail, and many more, and basically bring them into your system so that you've got a task dashboard. ClickUp, Notion, and many more work with this application to help bring and consolidate all your tasks in one location. So you can essentially take them from your inbox, drag them into your calendar, and essentially you've got time blocking here. There's also a function in settings called time locking, which basically, when you've blocked it out in your calendar, it blocks that time as busy. So there are other people that you may be working with or potentially external actually see that as busy time in your calendar. So you can do that inside of Akiflow, and you can even use the upcoming view to plan in a Kanban-like week view to help you organize those tasks that are coming up. But they've recently released something called time slots, which is like a third experience. So you can create an event, you can create a task, and you can naturally add them in your calendar or just in a task view. But naturally, inside of this new time slot view, you can create a slot of time, and this could be anything. In this example, I've got launch ad campaign, and basically this is a period of time that you're focusing on the task, but what it's going to do is add subtasks as part of that time slot. Now you can add subtasks below, and naturally it'll come up with all of the times that are, you know, all part of that time slot. But if you had a 2-hour time slot, for example, in this one we have a 1.5-hour time slot, you can actually choose individually what those subtasks, how long they're going to take, and when to actually start them. This helps break down the task, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to have a million tasks living everywhere. These three tasks live inside this time slot, keeping it neat and organized and really focused towards what you're working on. So this is perfect because you can also shuffle these around dependent on when you're working inside of this time slot, if things start to change and naturally adapt. But it helps you to keep focused on that session and not necessarily have to scroll on some paper what those subtasks are a part of it in an effort to try and keep your task management system organized. So time slots are naturally something you can create from scratch. If I were to drag what I believe to be an event in my calendar, you can naturally go and choose either a task, event, or slot. Now, you can give a slot a title. This could be like lists. Say I'm writing lists, I could be write lists, and then I can add the three lists that I'm working on. And this just literally helps to refine the process. So in this case, I can write calendar apps, because I'm gonna do a feature on that. And you can see at 1:30, 1:45, the calendar app appears. I could do daily plans. And this is where I can actually change the exact time. And if I click into it, the other task will appear and I can change the time to start it. And in this case, I can also change the duration to anything I'd like as well. And if I click out of it, I can see that these tasks are now naturally set up in a time slot function. And I can add more tasks to it if I want to. I can add a label to it and all of the other relevant things you'd expect. But this really keeps it condensed so that you're not overwhelmed by some of the systems inside of Akiflow. So at any time, if I think I want to change some of the details of this, I can add more context to each of the tasks, even giving it priority levels, assigning deadlines to it, and even moving it to the inbox too, which is all very helpful. And at any given point, if I actually wanted to focus in on a task, I can still use F to focus in on the task at hand. And naturally, I can see what the next task is up for me to do, which gives me a better insight, as well as being able to click into the future pieces and time slots that I have. So that was the time slot function in Akiflow. Let us know if you have any questions, but an interesting addition to their new experience and sort of solving the problem of time blocking, or at least the best that I've seen in the market of actually this being done at the moment. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this overview. If you're interested in Akiflow, you can check out a full review on toolfinder, or if you're interested, naturally, you can dive into it below and there's a discount coupon too. So thank you very much, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.